So as a brand or as a business owner, how do I protect myself online?
So connect with the marketplaces with all your registration documents. If at all any fake is spotted on any of the marketplaces that you are already listed, or there is, even if you are not listed and that the fake product is being listed over there without your permission, you can definitely reach out to the marketplace team, and they will either report abuse through their channel or connect with them, and they will definitely come back to you either by taking down those websites, or they would help you understand why the product is still being listed over there, because no marketplace will in its legal entity want to contribute to the menace of counterfeiting or even promote that.
Great. And by the way, we at Aquis have a tool called Truviz, which is specifically meant to do that. It can basically scan your presence online and make sure there's no form of impersonation. Absolutely. That happens. And that happens across marketplaces, social media, and also your domains as well, right? So do check out Truviz as well. Moving on, the next question is around, let's talk about deepfakes. We've seen and heard a lot about deepfakes and how it's been misused, and a lot of people have been affected by it. So when it comes to deepfakes, in fact, deepfakes is also used to fake a human, right? And sometimes we've seen videos of people, even though it's not them, deepfake has been used to fake a human. So when it comes to IP and deepfake, how are these two connected?
So the intellectual property laws in India and worldwide are also coping up with the advancing technologies, which is moving at a lightning speed. So in intellectual property rights, under the copyright law and trademark law, you do have measures where you can protect your voice and features of your character, inner personality trait as well, and get it protected and then claim also. So if anybody else in the name of deepfakes is taking up these activities, can be caught red-handed. And
so you're saying there are already laws which allow us to do that?
Yes, so copyright laws and trademark laws do have features which can help you out. Other than that, in addition to that, there are also personality rights.
Nice.
Which does exist in a few developed countries, not all developing countries or all other countries for sure. But as the intellectual property laws are developing, I'm sure most of the countries will adapt to it as well.
Quite interesting. I think I have something which probably a lot of us are not aware about, right? That you can even patent or trademark your personality.
Trademark your voice. In India, Amitabh Bachchan ji has done it.
Nice. Okay.
And a few other actors have also gone ahead and trademarked their voices.
Interesting.
And outside of India also, you can either get your voice trademarked or smell trademarked as well.
Interesting.
And that can help you further protection.
Nice. Great. So Ankita, you've had experience in brand protection. So somebody who's a brand protection manager, right? What's the advice you would like to give to him or her?
We do not have a culture of having an intellectual property department yet in every business in India. But as we know that businesses are growing, even from a startup level to a large entity, be it an MSME company as well, each of the business is creating intellectual property, right?
Mm.
So leaving it to only one person do all the talks, it is great to have intellectual property managers specifically attributed to not just take care of the registrations of intellectual property rights. That is definitely a foremost activity once you recognize your IP in your own company, but also look after the management aspect of it by creating different portfolios, follow different portfolio tools as well, where data related to the different types of IPs are stored in a customizable way or in a standard way for your company. So that portfolio can help you look at the overall viewpoint of the IP that exists in the company and help you again further maintain not just the records, but also know the validity of what is still available at your hand to commercialize and make economic benefits from those intellectual property rights for your company, and of course enforce your rights as and when required. For more details, the IP leaders or management leaders can also go through the course that we have recently launched for strategic IP being created for business leaders.
Nice.